sipping on booze in the house of blues. It's the O.
It's currently 8:10, and we plan to leave to go to Babylon at 8:30. So we're doing good. We've just packed the car. Brianna's just finished getting ready. As far as we know, we've got everything, like just all the essentials. I really don't know what to expect because I've never been there before, but I've only ever heard good things about it. Like last year, we went to Esoteric and not Babylon. They were like a week apart, but everyone was like, Babylon's amazing. Like you need to go. They have heaps of different stages, like a psych stage, techno stage, house stage. And they're really like focusing on like the environment, which is really good. I think that's important to, you know, look after the environment that you're partying on. Definitely important. No littering. If I see anyone littering, I'll roundhouse kick you. You get bad karma for littering, so people just don't do it. I'm gonna be driving there. I'm not driving home, don't worry. I'm getting my friends to pick me up on the Sunday. One of them is driving my car out. But it's 1.5 hours away, which is good. It's not too far. So I'm hoping like most people went a little bit earlier. And so when we get there, I'm hoping it's a breeze to get in and we don't have to fuck around too much. And then by midnight, we should be all in and partying. But yeah, I just wanted to quickly like start this video by saying I'm going to Babylon in like 20 minutes and I'm excited as. And so next time I'll be recording will be when I'm actually in there and it'll be dark. So I probably won't be able to show you like our setup, but it'll probably be at the stages. And I'm so keen to just get in there and quickly like get our shit together and then party. Party all night until the sun comes up. All right, I'll see you in there. What have we run into here? Say it ain't so. Say, oh yeah, bitch. Yes, yes. Oh my God.
I'm literally never leaving.
Oh, oh man, you're loving this shit. You're a Doof queen. This is this chick's first Doof. We've seen them at Let Go Fest. I said, come to Babylon, you will not regret it. We'll meet you there and look what they did. Doof queens. Doof queens. I taught you as well. Did I teach you as well?
Yes.
Yes.
Someone drop her off to you, obviously.
By the way, guys, it's a stage, but it's got like bed set up, so you can full on relax at the stages. Sick.
Fuck, I had pegs.
No, no, you can see on the wall part.
You do?
I had pegs.
Oh.
No, no, you're not too fucked up. No, no, on the top part.
This better work.
I hope, like, no.
There you go.
Yeah,
not good. Why do I look bad? What's going on here? The filter doesn't even do what the filter's meant to do.
Wait up. So, Babylon, definitely my favourite Doof now. Definitely. Yeah, the techno music. And we didn't realise how much we liked techno until we went to that techno stage and didn't want to leave. Like, it was so good. Yeah, I didn't even realise I was a massive techno fan until I went to Babylon. And then I was just like, this music just sucks you back in. Like, I just couldn't leave the stages. And, like, Babylon was the first festival ever that I was like, fuck it, I'm going to take my shoes off. I'm going to dance in the mud. Like, I'm just going to, you know, be a big kid.
It's good because Katie's birthday falls on Rainbow and my birthday falls on Babylon. So all of my girlfriends got me a birthday ticket to Babylon. And then we got a bamboo tent, which was really cool because it was already set up for us. It had two mattresses in there and it was just a little tent that was not going anywhere because usually at Doofs you find Doofnados.
Yeah, and then your whole campsite is falling apart with the bloody tornado. But with Bamping, you don't have to worry about that.
No, all set up for you. But we forgot the canopy to our gazebo.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a deal breaker, man.
Because it was going to be 36 on that Saturday and Brianna is a little Irish girl and she burns like that.
Allergic to the sun.
Yeah, pretty much allergic to the sun. And we didn't have a canopy, so she's like, what the fuck are we meant to do?
So we made friends. We made our neighbours.
We made friends.
But luckily, Katie's mum was an absolute legend and she came and dropped off the canopy and we had our new gazebo with new lights and all kinds of stuff all set up.
My mum's a legend. Shout out to you. She drove all the way, which was 2 hours away from where we live. So 4 hours of driving she did all together just to get this gazebo canopy to us.
Keep us safe, but we would have fried without it.
And I was like, Mum, I can't leave the festival. Oh yeah, this psychedelic brand, check them out, they're really cool. Space Cream Clothing. They reached out to me. They said, do you want to be like an ambassador? We'll send you these like 30% off or whatever. We're yet to take a really good photo with
them. I guess this is our photo.
But this is me giving Space Cream Clothing a shout out. This jumper is literally so thick. It's one of the ones that have like the fluff on the inside.
Just get real cold at night time, real hot throughout the day, real cold at night. You really need something like this to keep you warm.
Yeah, basically, moral of the story, if you're considering going to Babylon, but you're on the fence about it, definitely go. Take my advice and go, but get Bamping.
Make it easy.
Yeah, make it easy for yourself, because it's only $70 each if you're with two people. We ended up meeting two boys on the Saturday that took care of us.
Their whole group of friends.
Yeah. So shout out to Ducky.
Shout out to Kendall.
Yep, you know who you are.
Rabble, that's you.
Her with this guy, with this guy Ken. It was literally Barbie and Ken in the flesh. Like, I've never seen anything like it.
Instead, I was Barbie and he was Ken at one point.
I was convinced. It's true. Everyone was convinced. Yeah, Barbie and Ken do
it. Barbie and Ken get loose.
Barbie and Ken get loose.
Barbie and Ken get loose.
It's true.
Fucking mother goose.
Baba Bronx.